services, 6.45%. Those are adjustments in the insurance premium tax rates. And so a lot of places are seeing increases in that. And then fire services, 12.55%. There are some adjustments in there as far as moving the volunteers to part-time status and trying to overcome some of the staffing issues and overcomes. Under your capital projects fund, your SPOS and your T-SPOS are increasing. That again is, has to do with that sales tax revenues that are coming in there. Water sewer, 7.94% increase. That is a conservative estimate with the new system coming online and the new meters. What the impact that is going to be, we're not sure yet. Landfill, we have an increase of 6.62%. There's some additional maintenance and improvements at the landfill that are needed this year, as well as, you know, some things in the litter program. Tax planning districts, 4.83%. Again, this is just electricity costs, that and expansion of districts. We've had several districts added in the last year.
And we're still in the black.
We are still in the black. Inspections and permitting and quiet times, those are brand new departments. And these are, you know, the best estimates we have come up with based on all the research and the things that we need for those departments. Your internal service funds. Equipment maintenance is at 6.26%. That has to do with the number of vehicles, the age of vehicles, and then the cost of gas, parts, etc. Increasing. Very little change in health insurance or workers' comp, and some increased cost of technology as we add some new systems and add some new software programs on there. So overall, our total budget is $148 million, which is an 8.51% increase.
And that's pretty good considering what the way the inflation has been in the past year. It's only for inflation.
And that's adding a couple of funds.
Yeah.
And some other
things. The general fund, and I did this a little bit different than I normally did, because we do have some excess fund balance right now. There were a lot of things in the budget that people requested that were one-time type expenses, purchasing things if they're not recurring costs. And so to kind of address the situation with fund balance, I pulled those items out separately. And so what I presented is a budget that the operating part before those items balanced out, and then it's going to show a deficit budget that is going to come from that fund, the existing fund balance. Also, the way we did that is on the property taxes, we did not anticipate an increase in the dollar amount that we received from property taxes. Now, how that will
equate
to the village.
Okay.
It's not that what I want, but I'm fair.
Well, I think it'll give you the opportunity to get you what you want, is what it really means. They haven't figured in, I get this right now, they have not figured in these reevaluations. So they've stuck with the current numbers, and so what we don't know is until the digest comes in what that number is going to look like. So when you have the opportunity to set the village, you'll know what that number is and you can work off of that. But then you'll have that number by then without the digest.
I wish
set the millage.
Are those fund balance numbers in here anywhere?
Overall, under your revenues, there is an increase of 3.8% in taxes. That's primarily the TABT and the sales tax. Very little change in licensing, intergovernmental charges for service. A little bit of a decrease in funds and forfeitures. Investment income is back where it should be and was just a few years ago. A little bit of an increase in miscellaneous, which is where things like rents and all go. Resource officers in there as well. No change in the transfers. So we have total operating revenues of $68.4 million, which is a 4.32% increase. On the expenditure side, general government, there's an increase to 14.12%. There's some money added into the contingency for some things that are going on this year. There are several elections, monies in there. And then there's some additional monies in there for possible storms, et cetera. Judicial is at 4.16%. Public safety, 7.25%. Public Works is showing an 11.2% decrease. That is because under SDS, the agreement on dirt road maintenance, so there's a reduction of about $1.2 million there. I think that will come from the TIA funds. Health and welfare, culture and recreation, and housing development remain virtually the same. And then the transfers, which are used to support 911, are down about 7%. So your operating expenditures again are at 4.32%. So at that point, the budget is balanced. Then there's some additional capital one-time items that were requested in this budget, just under $1 million. And again, those are anticipated to come from fund balance. So again, this budget was based on no growth in the property tax revenues. And again, as I just said, this is presented as balance for operations with an additional investment for capital and other one-time purchases from existing fund balance. Just like last year, there's a higher and normal vacancy rate for personnel. A little bit more significant than last year in some departments. There are some new positions to address some needs. There's also some new positions for inspections, quiet times. Those are all added to personnel. As I said earlier, there is a COLA and merit included. There are reduction in the general fund expenditures for that dirt road maintenance per SDS. And then as far as the ABM project, we are starting to see a lot of savings in the energy, and we have the anticipation of the water sewer project going live this year. So can you see just a breakdown of the general fund revenues? The majority of that, 85.96%, is taxes. If you break that down, about 61% of that is property taxes. 28% is that local option sales tax, and 9% is the TABT. And then on the expenditure side, general government is just under 20% of your budget. Judicial is 11.5%, and the largest portion of that is public safety at 38.34%, and public works at 13.38%.
Questions, comments, report?
go for this in